What up, fam? It's Ali, and we are back. Charleston, West Virginia.
Heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home to the place.
Fam, so my bad for disappearing for so long. I had a whole lot on my agenda, things to do, but we out here in West Virginia and I didn't get to record too much out here. I was on a time crunch, but basically I had a few days to travel to a whole bunch of properties I wanted to check out, and I stayed in Charleston. That's where I'm at right now. I drove about an hour and a half north, went south, east, west, was all over the place. I feel like I got a good feel for West Virginia. Of course, there's a whole lot more to see, I know. But I'll put up a top 5 video about the likes and dislikes. And I was only in a small area, so take it for what it's worth. The top 5 give or so reasons why I wouldn't consider West Virginia to homestead. So, number 5, I have to say there's a lot of bugs. Snakes everywhere. At least the properties I checked out. Cicadas. If you guys don't know what that is, I'm from Cali. When I first came out here, one just flew into the car. They're basically giant flies, 1.5 inches. I shit you not. Number 4, privacy, fences. Some of the properties I checked out, being from California, to the people that are local, is probably no big deal, but your neighbors right next to you, your backyard, no fences. And if you buy a property and someone puts a trailer right next to you, you know, you really got to live with it. So if you invest out here, just be aware of that. Number 3, flooding. So there is a lot of rainfall out here. It's green for a reason. So you gotta be pretty conscious when you get a property where it's placed. If it's on the slope, if it's on the valley end, you can expect some flooding. Number 2, homes are a little bit older. So for my price range that I was looking to invest around that $300,000, the homes are a little bit old. So keep that in mind. Whether you're looking in the upstairs, the attic, the basement, you're gonna have some wear and tear, and you can tell the wood has gone through its life cycles. And the number one reason why I probably won't settle down in West Virginia, you could look at properties, Zillow, Redfin, and you'll see 15, 20 acres, but when you actually get out here, you'll notice it's rolling hills. So the home might be laid out in a very nice area right off the road, and you think, okay, I'm gonna look at the rest of the 15 acres, but the rest of the 15 acres is rolling hills. And some of the properties I looked at, 12 of those acres, they really don't use them. The last one that I visited, the lady said that she hunts in them. So there's deer, bear, turkey, and they leave it the way it is. So keep that in mind. All right, you guys got my top five why I might not pick West Virginia. But on the other end, my top five why I just might settle down in West Virginia. Number five, water is abundant. So everywhere is green for a reason. Whether you want to dig a well or you want to collect rainwater, water is abundant. Reason number four, a lot of people told me it's really hot out here, it's humid, but to be honest, I like the weather. You know, I visited my brother in Riverside, California, in Sacramento, California, and man, I know what humidity is. But I'm out here for a few days, I feel the humidity, but it's not really hot. Like in Sacramento, it's so dang hot, you get in your car and you burn. All right, and the number three reason why I might just settle in West Virginia is beautiful, man. Everything is green, it's peaceful. You could hear the insects, they just chirp like that, but you don't hear like loud music or, you know, people arguing, nothing like that. You really are in nature, and everywhere around you there's creeks, running rivers. I don't know what this is behind me, maybe a lake, a canal, but right in front of the Capitol building, it's beautiful. And the number two reason why you would settle in West Virginia is very affordable, especially if you have Cali money or something like that. You could come out here, $300,000 around there, and I think you could find a place to stay. The cost of living is really low, taxes really low. I'm not sure what the tax is around here, but the food I had, I think it was about 6 or 7%, and it changed, but a lot less than California. And the number one reason you want to live in West Virginia, everyone is super polite. When people drive by, they wave at you. You think they might honk, but they wave at you. And people walking by, the park rangers, the landscape people, everybody just says hello. The realtor I was hanging out with showing me property was really cool. Even drove like an hour to show me a property. So really, really nice people in West Virginia. That's probably one of the biggest perks. Being from California, that's pretty unique. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please keep in mind, I was only out here for a few days, and all my journey in West Virginia was pretty much around Charleston, Virginia. So take it for what it's worth. And the West Virginians, please don't get upset if I say anything you don't approve of. Look at this sketchy road. I don't know if you guys can see it, but that is crazy. Their roads are wild. And you gotta pretty much share this. So if a car comes on that side, we gotta share it. Look how sketchy this is. Over the railroad. Charleston, West Virginia. Late night mission of Burger King.